this podcast, we'd like to give you an insight into the new features of EDIUS 9.52. EOS 1DX Mark III support, proxy workflow with EOS C500 Mark II, extended AAF export, consistency check for restoring offline clips. EOS 1DX Mark III support. Canon is currently launching a new top-of-the-range 1DX camera, the EOS 1DX Mark III. It is the first DSLR camera with internal RAW recording, up to 5.5K. The frame rate can be set to 60p or even as high as 120p in full HD. The maximum bitrate of 2600 megabits is very high. With EDIUS 9.52, it is possible to process all recordings of the EOS 1DX Mark III. When processing, Canon RAW is accelerated by the graphics card. Open the system settings and go to Importer Exporter Cinema RAW GPU. Here, you can use CUDA or OpenCL as acceleration technology. Proxy workflow with EOS C500 Mark II. Canon will soon release the new C500 Mark II camera. This camera can record in RAW and offers the possibility to create proxy files at the same time. Compared to the high-resolution RAW files, the proxies are relatively small. This enables faster processing. The proxies can be transferred directly from the camera to the editing station via FTP or from the memory card via laptop. The editor can import the proxies directly, insert them into the timeline, and edit them as required. EDIUS already enables a Sony XAVC proxy workflow. With EDIUS 9.52, a Canon XF AVC proxy workflow is now supported. This offers great advantages. The C500 Mark II camera records RAW video on a compact flash express card, while the proxies are simultaneously written on an SD card. For the proxy workflow in EDIUS 9.52, import the proxy files directly from the bin window. The XF AVC proxy files are located in the Clips folder, which can be found in the Contents folder. EDIUS correctly recognizes the files as Canon XF AVC proxy files. This is indicated by an icon in the top right corner of the thumbnail. Edit your project with the proxies as usual. As soon as the high-resolution material of the compact flash express card is available, you can replace the proxies with the RAW. To do this, go to the source browser. If the files are still on the card, it will automatically appear in the Cinema RAW folder. If you have previously transferred the material with the complete folder structure to your hard drive, you have to add the location of your card manually by right-clicking. EDIUS automatically recognizes that proxies can be replaced with high-resolution material. Confirm that you want to replace, and then click OK in the subsequent dialog window. Extended AAF export. There is also news regarding the AAF export. AAF is used to exchange files between different programs within a production process. The format ensures that the files can still be read by other applications after they have been edited. With EDIUS 9.52, you can now output AAF files via the normal export dialog. Previously, AAF export was only possible via the Export Project AAF menu item. Now it is also available in the regular export window under the menu item Others AAF Project Exporter. By including the AAF exporter in the export dialog, extended options are now possible. For example, adding a visible timecode. Batch export or configuration as a standard export is now also available. Consistency check for restoring offline clips. There are also innovations in the restoration of offline clips. As soon as you want to restore offline clips, EDIUS 9.52 displays the result of a consistency check. This way, you can see immediately whether, for example, the contents of the files or the clip lengths do not match. Click here for the next podcast. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. Visit EDIUS.NET for more information about EDIUS, plugins, tutorials, and the latest downloads.